meet Playboy's Miss September 1980, Lisa Welch Semler. Miss July 1981, Heidi Sorensen. Miss January 1982, Kimberly MacArthur. Miss October 1989, Karen Foster. Miss June 1985, Devin DeVasquez. Centerfolds of the 1980s. Ready for action. Playing against Miss January 1976, Dana House. Playmate of the Year 1978, Deborah Jo Fondren. Playmate of the Year 1974, Cindy Wood. Miss May 1979, Michelle Drake. Playmate of the Year 1979, Monique St. Pierre. Centerfolds of the 1970s. On your marks. For Family Feud's monumental, earth-shaking Battle of the Centerfold. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Cole.
Thank you. Thank you so very much. Welcome to our Centerfolds of the 70s, playing against Centerfolds of the 80s. Thank you. Thank you so very much. What a lucky crowd, and we appreciate you tuning in. It's a very special show, backed by popular demand. We have on this stage 11 of the most beautiful people. 10.5 of the most beautiful people in the planet. They're going to compete to see who will be called the champions of Family Feud, playing for their favorite charities. They are the Centerfolds of the 80s. Kimberly MacArthur. My hand is cold.
Yeah,
I'm nervous.
I'll warm it up.
All right. Let me try to solve the puzzle now. Oh, I'm a little disoriented when you grab my hand.
Let me just ask you the question, baby.
Oh. Well, I don't know the question, but the answer is yes. You're playing for a wonderful charity.
We are. It's the Children of the Night organization. And what they do is they offer shelter, a phone call, food, sometimes just a sympathetic ear to teenagers who have run away from home.
Who are homeless and are away from home. $10,000 could go to that fine charity if our Centerfolds of the 80s can defeat the Centerfolds of the 70s. Dana, how are you? Dana House, you are January 1976, and we know who you're playing with. We heard that introduction. Welcome you. Now, you've got a great charity you're playing for. Gene, do I seem like I'm having a hard time talking? It's not so much talking, it's breathing. And that's making me... Thank you, Dana, for rubbing my back. Let's see you get in the star over that. Who are you playing for?
I'm playing for Operation USA.
Which is?
It's an international relief fund for national disasters.
Well, excellent. We got two great charities, 10 beautiful women, and we want to give away $10,000. We got to play the feud. Let's go. Right now, Kimberly. Good luck. We don't get to touch anybody here today. The first team to 300 will play for the $10,000. The top five answers are on that board. Who will it be? We ask 100 people, try to find most popular to this. Name something that people rehearse. Kimberly?
Musicals.
How about a musical? Let me see.
Yeah.
It's there. Stay right here, Kimberly. Three answers. Dana could give you control. Something that people rehearse.
Speeches.
They do rehearse a speech.
Good.
Number three, think of a steal. Centerfolds of the 80s. Deborah Jo, I gotta get my hand warm.
Hello, darling.
Oh, hello, darling, to you. Now, we are looking for something that people rehearse.
They rehearse their lines.
Speaking as an actress, they do rehearse their lines. Number two, we are working our way up to the most popular answer. Now, that says Michelle, doesn't it?
Yes.
I would actually reach over there to move the hair, but I'm afraid I could get in big trouble. So I'll try to... There you go. Well, let me just... I did it. I touched her, guys. Uh-huh. All right. Something that people rehearse.
Wedding vows.
Rehearse them. That's the easy part. Living them is another thing. Let me see. Rehearsing the wedding vows. A wedding. Nicely done. Cindy...
Hi, how are you?
What a grip. Let me get in there. Nice to see you. Nice to see you. Now, your team has no strikes. The women of the 80s over there look a little dejected, but beautiful. Something that people rehearse.
What to say on a first date?
Okay, could I ask Judge what she might rehearse saying on a first date without giving... What might you say on a first date? What would you rehearse?
I would rehearse... Hello.
All right. Nothing like being prepared. Get mixed up and go, hell. Oh. Let me see. Rehearsing for a first date. What to say? One strike.
Darling.
Monique.
Hello.
What? The voices alone I would pay to hear. Something that people rehearse.
Dance.
They do rehearse. Yeah. And you got the bank on a clean sweep if we see a dance. Strike number two. Centerfolds of the 80s, that bank could be yours. Dana, you can stop them. Thank you for letting that breath out.
I don't know, an oral test.
An oral test.
A test.
Something people rehearse. What do you say? Is that the answer, Judge? She's committed to a test. You've got a clean sweep. If we see test, 'tis not there. The bank could still be yours unless the women of the 80s name something that people rehearse. One answer.
Sports.
Sports?
A TV show.
TV show. Lisa. TV show.
TV okay. show. TV yeah, show. TV
now, Kimberly,
show,
with them or out on your own, tell her what you want her to say.
TV show.
You got 3 seconds. You can do it.
Sports.
They rehearse sports. Now, you've stolen that first bank and are on your way to $300 if we see sports. It's all right. We heard television show. One answer would have stolen the bank. Our survey said that people rehearse number 5. Asking your boss. Sucking up. Didn't make the survey. All right. We're coming back with a beautiful view right after this. We're going to play for a wonderful charity, $10,000. Hurry back. Try. You guys got to get these hands warm. I don't usually have cold. Maybe you. Welcome back to this most special feud, $96 for the Playboy Centerfolds of the 70s. Centerfolds of the 80s have 0. Here we go with another face-off. Good luck, Karen. Deborah, Joe, the top 6 answers are on the board. Pay attention. We'll move quickly. We ask 100 people, name something that if you don't learn to do it as a child, you probably won't ever learn to do it. Deborah Joe.
Ride a bicycle.
How about riding a bike? It's number 2. One answer, Karen, could give you control. Something that if you don't learn to do it as a child, you probably won't ever learn to do it.
To read.
Maybe reading. It's there, but it is number 3. There you go. Well, even if you can't read, you can always look at the pictures. That's what I like about some things. All right, there's 4 answers on the board. Think about it. That was a good joke. Michelle?
Swim!
If you don't learn to do it as a child, maybe you'll never learn how to swim. Number 1. Cindy. You've got that look like you don't quite know. Take a guess.
Okay, if you don't learn how to...
do it as a child, you probably won't ever learn to do it. 3 seconds.
3 seconds.
Take a guess. That's only 1 strike. Think. Fine over there. All right, Monique, keep the team rolling.
Okay.
Well, the crowd is really behind you guys.
How about ice skate?
It's very hard in your older years to learn to ice skate.
Is that good?
Think of a steal. You got the chance and didn't do it. Dana, what do you say?
Okay, I say, if you don't learn how to be polite and have manners when you're a child, you will never be polite and have manners when you get older.
Well, you know, that's one of those answers that's so wonderful that you should just get a round of applause for it, even if it's not up there. Let me see. If you don't learn manners, you'll never learn them.
Thank you very much, even if it's not up there.
It's an excellent answer. Boy, these girls are beautiful and smart. Deborah Jo.
Come on, Deborah Jo. All the good ones are taken.
That kind of seems like you were on Petticoat Junction. There's Deborah. No, it was Uncle Joe. There's Deborah Jo, and she's moving kind of slow.
Oh, this is true.
What do you say? You got a clean sweep and a big lead.
Oh, my gosh. Skip rope?
How about jumping rope? You're going to get a chance to steal. Centerfolds of the 80s, if Michelle doesn't know. What do you say?
Talk.
How about talk? Let's see if they can steal the bank. You can get in the game if you name something that if you don't learn to do it as a child, you probably won't ever learn to do it. One answer.
Ski. Gymnastics.
Gymnastics, Lisa?
To love yourself.
Love yourself?
To be neat.
To be neat. Tell her what you want her to say. Again, only one answer will steal that bank. What would it be?
To write.
Okay.
You're going with?
To write.
Will the women of the 80s get on the board with writing? No, sir. That bank goes to our centerfolds of the 70s. Here it is. The one answer in our survey that would have got you in the game. If you don't learn to do it as a child, number 6, you may never learn to do it. Play a musical instrument. We are coming back. You got to go all the way to $300 to play for that $10,000. Hurry back. You don't want to miss this one. Don't give up. Double that dollar value. Let's double the dollar value now and give the women of the 80s a chance to get in this game. Top 5 answers are on the board. We ask 100 people this question. Name someone who plays a big part in your important decisions. Michelle.
Father.
How about your father? It is their parents. Now listen carefully, Lisa. It's a very important question for your team. One answer could give you control. Someone who plays a big part in your important decisions.
My husband.
Yes. Are you married?
Yes.
Okay. Forget it, Gene. All right, let me see. Husbands. Number 1. Think of a steal, women of the 70s. Now let me point out, it is all important that you take this question all the way out to get in the game, but if you give them the chance to steal, and they do, they'll win. Devin, you're bouncing up and down. You have one of the answers.
Yes.
What do you say?
Teachers.
Someone who plays a big part in your important decisions?
Right.
Is there one specific teacher that comes to mind for you?
No. Every one of them has a special something about them, I think.
Oh, what a wonderful. Well, I just want to say there was a couple of mine I couldn't stand. They were not nice to me, but most teachers are great. Let me see a teacher. Sensitive of you to say that. Heidi.
Yes.
Heidi. Hi. Now, what month were you?
I was July 81.
July of 81. I was April 56. That was my birthday. Yeah. That's not centerfold. What would you say? Before you made an important decision, who plays a big part in that?
How about your employer?
Employer?
Yes.
Let me see if it's up there. The employer. 2 strikes. Women of the 70s, you want to think of a steal because if by chance the lovely Kimberly cannot give me one of those remaining 3 answers, this game is up for grabs. Name someone who plays a big part in your important decisions.
The religious leader in your life, your pastor, your minister.
Okay. The religious leader in your life. Is that not the same as your wife sometimes is like God? Is that not the same? Okay, yes, all right, let me see. At my house, let me see a religious leader. Not on the survey. Excellent answer, Kimberly. Now, carefully, if you give me one answer to help the head of your team, you've won the game. Someone who plays a big part in your important decisions. Monique, one answer.
Lawyer,
Cindy?
Children.
Michelle.
Analyst,
Deborah Jo?
Best friend.
Your best friend? Help her, there's 3 answers. One will win you this game.
Lawyer.
What do you say?
Lawyer.
I'm going to say you're lawyer.
Lawyer. If it is there, you've won the game. Show me lawyer. Tis not. The women of the 80s are in this game. Here are the 3 answers that would have won it for you. Important decisions, people consult number 3. Bam, sweetheart. People consult number 4. Your children. Said by who? Said by Cindy. No one said it. Number 5. God. Well, not quite. Here we go with another face-off. Here we go. We will triple the dollar value. Whoever takes this question will win the game. Pay attention, we will move very quickly now. We ask 100 people. Name something you would have seen on a city street in the early 1900s that you wouldn't see today. You would. Cindy?
A Model T.
How about a Model T? It's there. Three answers more popular, Devin. You would have seen in the early 1900s on city streets you wouldn't see today.
Horses.
Show me a horse. Tis number one. Here come the women of the 80s. Heidi, something you would have seen on city streets in the 1900s early, but you wouldn't see today. You can win the game.
Indians?
How about maybe an Indian? What do you say, Kimberly?
1900s would have been...
The early 1900s.
Early, I was around then. Gas lamps.
How about a gas lamp? Exactly as it is on our survey. Karen, give me number three. You're going to be playing for your wonderful charity, Children of the Night.
How about cobblestones?
Yeah. Is it cobblestones? Think of a steal. What do you say, Lisa?
Hoop skirts.
Hoop skirts for the game. Could it be hoop skirts? No! If you fail to give me number three, they win. Something you would have seen on the city streets early 1900s you wouldn't see today.
Parasols?
Parasol, Cindy? Doesn't know anything?
The Iceman.
Iceman?
Street vendors.
Street vendors? Tell her. One answer will steal you this game. What drama? The women of the 70s? I need an answer in 3 seconds.
Parasols.
You're playing for $10,000 for your wonderful charity if we see Parasol. This would have won you the game. Number three in the early 1900s, hitching pose for those horses. I need two players right now for $10,000 for the Children of the Night. Who's first? Bye-bye. We're coming right back with two beautiful women and a wonderful charity. Don't go away. For $10,000, we put 15 seconds on that clock. We wish the Playboy Centerfolds of the 80s much luck for the charity, the Children of the Night. We ask 100 people these five questions. The first one, we ask 100 women. Name something you buy for your hair.
Hairspray.
A specific occupation at a circus.
Pass.
A piece of information on a party invitation.
Time.
Something viewers do during a TV commercial.
Food.
Something you do when you say goodbye to someone.
Kiss.
So, turn around. Let's see how you did. You got four of the five quite nicely. We asked 100 women something that you buy for your hair. You said hairspray. The survey said you're on the board with 25. Specific occupation at a circus, you thought. Didn't get it? All right. Piece of information on a party invitation, you said. The time. What'd the survey say? 34, making up for the last one. Something viewers do during a TV commercial, you said. Eat food, the survey said. Oh, 41 right at 100. Something you do when you say goodbye to someone, you said. You kissed them, survey said. 21, I say goodbye to you. So good enough, there was no kiss. Here comes your partner, who's been kept off stage. Karen, look straight ahead. As we put 20 seconds on that clock, you are 79 points away. From $10,000 for your charity, we ask 100 people this question. The first one, we ask 100 women. Something you buy for your hair.
Shampoo.
A specific occupation at a circus.
Juggler.
A piece of information on a party invitation.
RSVP.
Something viewers do during a TV commercial.
Eat.
Try again.
Go to the bathroom.
Something you do when you say goodbye to someone.
Kiss them.
Try again.
Hug them.
Turn around. 79 points from 10,000 for the Children of the Night. Something you buy for your hair, you thought our women said. You buy shampoo, what'd the survey say? Bam! Number one answer, shampoo. You are now 31 points away, specific occupation at a circus, you thought. Juggler, what'd the survey say? Two. Clown, number one. A piece of information on a party invitation, you thought. RSVP, the survey said. Seven, time was number one. 22, inching your way up. Something viewers do during a TV commercial, you said. Go to the bathroom. Did 22 people say it? For $10,000 for the Children of the Night, what did our survey say? You! The centerfold of the 80s, give $10,000 those are the children of the night. We're coming back with the number one answers. Don't go away. Go to bathroom number one when you have a TV commercial. Hug when you say goodbye to someone. For the Feud, we'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
A member of our studio audience will receive Dean Woods speaking for Family Feud, a Mark Goodson television production. September 1980, Lisa Welch-Semler. Miss July 1981, Heidi Sorensen. Miss January 1982, Kimberly MacArthur. Miss October 1989, Karen Foster. Miss June 1985, Devin DeVasquez. Centerfolds of the 1980s. Ready for action. Playing against Miss January 1976, Dana House. Playmate of the Year 1978, Deborah Jo Fondren. Playmate of the Year 1974, Cindy Wood. Miss May 1979, Michelle Drake. Playmate of the Year 1979, Monique St. Pierre. Centerfolds of the 1970s. On your mark. For Family Feud's monumental, earth-shaking Battle of the Centerfold. With the star of Family Feud, Ray Cole.
Thank you. Thank you so very much. Welcome to our Centerfolds of the 70s. Play against Centerfolds of the 80s. Thank you. Thank you so very much. What a lucky crowd, and we appreciate you tuning in. It's a very special show. Backed by popular demand, we have on this stage 11 of the most beautiful people. 10.5 of the most beautiful people in the planet. They're going to compete to see who will be called the champions of Family Feud, playing for their favorite charities. They are the Centerfolds of the 80s. Kimberly MacArthur. My hand is cold.
Yeah,
I'm nervous.
Warm it up.
All right.